Hi, welcome to the Hackers and Designers Summer Academy 2017 here at the Sluisdeuren Load of MediaMatic. My name is Anja Groten. I'm one of the organizers of Hackers and Designers. The other two organizers are Selby Gerdemacher, who raises a hand now. Thanks. Selby is an artist whose work I would describe as special and performative and multimedia. And James is a developer in the back. Raise your hand, James. That's James. James Brian Graves is a developer of software and also community organizer of the community Hackers and Founders, which we board and naming Hackers and Designers. And Hackers and Founders is a place where entrepreneurs and developers can rent desks and do a lot of other amazing things. Hackers and Designers started as a meetup community in 2013. And we started, it kind of came out of a conversation between the three of us, and we were all kind of frustrated with experiences in collaboration between the different disciplines. We realized that there was a lot of commonality, but also a lot of friction arising in collaboration, and that came mostly out of different ways of approaching projects and also using different language. So we started these meetups where we would invite one maker, like programmer, and one designer or artist to give hands-on workshops to each other. So we kind of wanted to bridge this verbal friction, or like all these arguments you have in collaboration where you think you don't understand each other, but actually you might, by just not talking and start making together. So now Hackers and Designers has grown up a little bit, and we do more things than organizing meetups. We organize bigger events, of which one is this Hackers and Designers Summer Academy. But we also advise artists, for example, or we give workshops abroad and in the Netherlands to students. But basically our main goal of creating this kind of safe space for things to fail, to focus more on process, has remained constant throughout the years. So we're here tonight for the special occasion of the grand finale of the Hackers and Designers Summer Academy 2017. This is an annual two-year workshop program, so also here, like, hands-on means of learning are in the focus. And we organize this program for makers that are interested in collaboration and especially in self-initiation and taking ownership of their own production. And also makers that are willing to challenge themselves in making useless stuff. That's really important. So our participants from this year, who I would like to stand up so you actually see their faces, they like responsible for all these amazing things that are around here. Yay! So they actually are coming from all over the world. Some examples of countries represented are Russia, Germany, France, Slovakia, Taiwan, China, Switzerland, Britain, Austria, and of course the Netherlands. And the topic of this year's Summer Academy, which is the third edition, is on and off and or off the grid. We invited 10 makers, amongst which designers, artists, engineers, biohackers, to investigate with us the possibilities of disconnecting from existing grids and networks and possibly creating our own alternatives, all through hands-on means of making learning. To give a little overview of what happened the last 2 weeks, we launched into the Summer Academy with an introduction workshop in Terminal and Python by James, and continued with a two-day workshop by the Things Network, who will tell you more about the organization later. Apart from learning how to solder, which was the first time for some of the participants, we learned how to make our own nodes and how to create a network which can be used, for example, for having smart devices at your home, and that work or connect with each other without using Wi-Fi or 3G. And Gottfried Heider's workshop, who's also one of the artists exhibited with those window blinds, we were reimagining smart. So it was a really nice follow-up of the Things Network workshop, and we turned the approach around. So we basically made first objects with paper mache, which was amazing to do. Everyone knows it from like childhood. And after we made these objects, we brought them to life the next day. And a lot of those projects have become reactions and almost like satire on the developments of the Internet of Things. In Sarah Garcin's workshop, at the end of the first week, we were introduced to her PJ machine, which you also see here, the publishing jockey machine, which is a work that critically investigates graphical user interfaces, and especially in the context of the graphic design practice. So she's actually questioning that we just keep on using all these corporate tools, and what she proposes is to create a new tool for every new project you will do. So we got to create our own PJ machines during her workshop. And some outcomes were, for example, using a smartphone as a remote control and using all the sensors. And by using them like this, you would move the layout and the content. Another one was using facial recognition to design the layout of a page. It was also around that time that we had Sarah's workshop that we found out that one of our workshop tutors, Bongani Riki Mazuku, an inventor from Zimbabwe, won't be able to travel to the Netherlands. His visa request was rejected for a second time. And despite of all the, we organized a lot and got a lot of recommendation letters, a lot of really amazing people and institutes wrote letters that this guy really needs to come to the Netherlands. He was rejected. Which is, of course, an organizational challenge, because you have to find an alternative that's appropriate, which is almost impossible because he's really amazing maker. But, of course, also challenged us in ways that it put a mirror in front of your nose saying, like, well, you're really privileged, you know. We didn't even consider that this would be a problem. We just go to airports and expect to go travel whenever we want. So that was a bit of a downer this year, but we did find an alternative, which was really amazing. Dennis DeBell, he gave a workshop the last 2 days here, and it was really, really great experience. But to give a little bit of an insight in this whole process of inviting Bongani, we printed all his, the letters of recommendation, also his rejection letter. So there's a whole pile there, if you're interested. And he made a really nice documentation of his workshop preparations. Also, what you see here is the chicken feeding robot that he built. So you can still enjoy his presence in one way. So we were really lucky to find an exciting alternative workshop tutor, which is Dennis DeBell, who taught us about edible computing and transmission of signals from A to B in very unusual ways. And the participants are very happy to tell you more about the workshop. Stefan Chale, whose work you see here, taught us about the diverse facets of camouflage making at the beginning of this week. And the Center for Genomic Gastronomy, whose work you see in the back, who are also our guest speakers tonight, they made us part of their endophyte collectors club and had us explore and breed on the biodiversity of Amsterdam Noord. Yesterday we moved the whole summer academy here to be able to accommodate more people for this event. And that's, I think, also a nice bridge to introduce you to our exhibition, our exhibition curator, Margarita Ozipian. But before I hand over, I want to very much thank all the participants of the Hexen Designer Summer Academy 2017. You are amazing, and I'm really I'm really touched that you committed so much throughout these 2 weeks and made so much production. We have a documentation made where you can see all the projects listed, and it's like an idea book. It's very rich and it's really great. So furthermore, I want to thank Spectral Utilities, who let us use their solar trailer, which enabled us to power a big part of the Summer Academy on solar energy. And not use the electrical grid of the Ramte so much. And then I want to thank the Stimulierungsfonds Kreative Industrie, of course, who fund Hackers and Designers activities of 2017, and the AFK, who supported the exhibition. And I want to thank Mediamatic for their generosity, support and trust, and especially for feeding us with amazing food for the last 2 days. And last but not least, I want to thank our amazing, talented volunteers, Vicky De Visser and Karina Zavidova, who's still folding booklets over there. And of course, a big thank you to Margarita Ozipian, our curator, for her patience and her professionalism. And I hand over the mic to you. Thank you.
Thank you, Anya. That was a very comprehensive view of the Summer Academy. I want to thank the hackers and designers, Anya and Selvi and James, for inviting me. It was a really great experience, a really interesting experience. Anya said a lot about the sort of context around the program, and I'm just going to give a tiny context about the exhibition. To kind of get into this whole idea of like going on off the grid and this process of making, we also made the exhibition a process of making. So it actually has started on the 31st of July at the Ramte, and it slowly grew from there. So it was like a cumulative exhibition. So as workshop leaders showed up, they would add their work to the exhibition. And as participants made projects, they would slowly build them up, and we could kind of see how everything was growing. So you guys get like the kind of finished version here in the final space, but it was a really nice process of sort of slowly building up what Anya called like a prototype exhibition, which I really liked, and the final outcome is here. And I think some of the participants will be kind of standing near their pieces in the break, and you'll get a chance to talk to them about what they're making and check everything out. I'm gonna just give a little rundown of what it's gonna be like. So we're gonna start with Stephen Pemberton, and then we're gonna hear from the Things Network. Then we'll have like a 30-minute break, and people who just showed up can see the exhibition at that time. And then we have Phoenix Perry, who came here all the way from London, which was really great. Drove through the tunnel. No, stuck her car on a train that went through the tunnel. And we're going to finish off with the Center for Genomic Astronomy, and it's going to be really fun. They're going to do some live plating of the plant samples, and there'll even be some time for visitors to maybe plate a little bit or watch some plating happen up close.